For some reason, KaguraBachi is becoming a buzz overseas for no particular reason. Oh boy, let's go. Hey, what's good, gamers? So last time we talked about KaguraBachi here, so yeah, basically KaguraBachi is this new manga, Shounen Jump manga, which has literally blown up over quite a short time, and literally it blew up overnight. So yeah, naturally since it blew up in the West, the Japanese audience over at Japan did have some bit of astonishing reaction, to say the least. So yeah, today we're just gonna be looking at some of these comments made by Japanese fans over in Japan over on Twitter. So yeah, I just got these over on Reddit, so yeah, here's a nice compilation of them. So yeah, let's begin. So our first comment comes from this person over here. For some reason, KaguraBachi is becoming a buzz overseas for no particular reason. Oh boy. I mean, like, I wonder what they would think if they understood the memes and the type of irony in them. Yeah, but yeah, I don't know how to what extent they understand the memes or not. But yeah, sadly, this is just... Yeah, let's move on to the next one. No comments there. Is KaguraBachi already popular overseas? Yeah, I mean, naturally they think that it's genuinely popular, but sadly it's just a meme. So yeah, although it is quite a great series on a serious note, I mean, the initial premise is quite promising, even though it's been criticized so much. And naturally, our next comments are just questions. Why is KaguraBachi so popular overseas? And to that we have a reply saying, dismemberment and bleeding are commonplace in their foreign manga, so I think people like KaguraBachi because they can read it with the same feeling. So yeah, there's the common assumption that since KaguraBachi has a darker tone to it, it's probably the more liked manga, which may not be wrong actually. But the main reason for its popularity does come from the fact that it became a meme for the sake of being a meme, and to replace Morbius and become the Morbius of the anime and manga community. But yeah, it just feels that this was kinda enforced for that reason rather than the fact that KaguraBachi has a darker vibe. But yeah, that does play a factor into it since Morbius is a dark theme series as well. But yeah, or well, a movie. But anyways, up next. The new Jump series KaguraBachi is really interesting since it deals with Japanese swords. I'm sure this will be popular overseas as well. Well, he called it. And next we have this person saying, KaguraBachi seems to be very popular overseas because it is a sword. As expected. Yep, he called it as well, I guess. Although for different reasons. Well, it does seem like they did call it out, but yeah, their reason. Yeah, if only they knew why it's actually popular overseas, but yeah. Up next, KaguraBachi, hashtag KaguraBachi, is where you can see reviews for KaguraBachi overseas. Or rather, it's completely lined up with the early post I found, tagged by chance while searching for review posts, and it seems to be quite popular for a new series. Is it really a sword? Well, yeah, it's basically just questions regarding KaguraBachi being a sword, and since that's where the namesake comes from for the title of the series anyways. So yeah, and yeah, it is pretty popular overseas, so I mean, can you really dispute that? I mean, it's literally been the most trending thing for quite a few days now. And up next we just have a similar tweet. The new Jump series KaguraBachi has only had one episode, but it has already been strangely well received overseas and is even creating a realistic anime image. Japanese sword power is amazing. And then we have an image of Chihiro. I can't allow slime like you to wield katana. Yay. So yeah, he does have a point. I find it interesting that Google Translate the chapter as episode. I mean, I wonder though, why did it do that? Up next, we also have KaguraBachi. I looked it up on KaguraBachi and it's been buzzing on TikTok, which makes me laugh. It's extremely popular overseas. I mean, considering how... I wonder though, what I'm curious about is why would they find it funny? Like, there are a few reasons as to why they could find it funny. Is it funny because they did not like KaguraBachi as a series over at Japan, or is it funny because they know it's a meme? Or, well, I mean, naturally, they will find out that it is a meme. But yeah, that's since everyone's been so astonished so far. Up next, we have why is KaguraBachi being such a joke overseas? Yeah, I guess since these are the later comments, yeah, it makes sense as to why they're catching on to why it is a meme. And, well, since the translate function exists over there as well, it's kinda easy to tell. KaguraBachi is incredibly popular overseas, and let's move on next. Even though only one episode of KaguraBachi has been released, isn't it very popular among overseas fans? And with two question marks ahead. Yep. Again, that's something I find interesting. Episode chapter translates over as episode. I keep getting a lot of tweets about KaguraBachi from foreigners. I think it will be popular overseas. Yep. I mean, I do think since Jujutsu Kaisen got so popular and Demon Slayer as well, they may be onto something with anime with darker vibes being popular. I do kind of expect that as well, as I said in my video last time. But yeah, KaguraBachi, huge buzz over, especially overseas. Weekly Jump 42. KaguraBachi has already been well received overseas. We have someone with a Zamasu profile picture here. KaguraBachi's Gaison Sensei's account has received a lot of compliments in foreign languages, and I think that a work with strong illustrations like that will be popular overseas. Yep, he's actually right. Pirate version of KaguraBachi has been leaked overseas and has been getting a lot of attention. Pirated version, yeah, that makes sense since I would guess that those mangas, well, the Weekly Jump volumes that people have been posting on Reddit are probably not legit. So yeah, that's probably what this is about. The number of likes on KaguraBachi is amazing overseas. Yep, I can't even argue with that. KaguraBachi battle scene is so cool. Buchi den Nirvana Nishiki. Even TikTok seems to be amazing. Even before it was serialized, it was extremely popular with people overseas. The story has a good tempo and illustrations are good, so I have high expectations. Get your jumping momentum back. Yay. No matter how much KaguraBachi is, the first episode is probably too popular overseas, which is why it was put in the new Big Gen 3 after the first episode. Nah, I don't think that's why it was put in the new Big 3, but yeah. That's about how much the comments are, so yeah. Basically, long story short though, for those who skipped ahead, I guess. Yeah, it does seem like a lot of Japanese fans are quite surprised that KaguraBachi has been so popular overseas. Like, I kinda expected in my video that I did expect the author to be amazed, and he probably is. But yeah, I do find it interesting that a lot of them are saying that darker stories get more popularity overseas, but I do think that a lot of lighthearted series do get a lot of popularity as well, since that's what a lot like Spy Family, for example, and My Dress Up Darling, those are more lighthearted than they are dark series. Like, yeah, that's what I think. So yeah, I do think they have this impression that those are the types of series that get popular overseas, but yeah, I mean, honestly, that they are probably not even wrong though, since and Demon Slayer and Jujutsu Kaisen are, but blew up recently. So yeah, that's basically these reactions, in my personal opinion, are pretty interesting, but yeah, these are, well, they're less surprised, that's something. Well, Japanese people are pretty smart, so yeah, that's basically it. So anyways guys, I'll probably wrap up the video now, so thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed today's content, make sure to like and make sure to subscribe, since a lot of you watching are not subscribed. So yeah, this has been Doran, and I'll see you next time. Cheers gamers, have a good one. Bye!